Welcome to my pick a card channel, the Tarot Cottage. My name is Amy. I'm here with a pick a card reading for you. A big welcome back to my beautiful returning subscribers. Thank you so much for all of your beautiful comments this month. A big thank you to everyone who has dropped comments for your chance to win a free tarot reading. And if you are new to the channel, I do offer a chance to win a reading for my subscribers as a thank you for your presence here. And all you have to do is drop your comment beneath any of my videos this month for your chance to win. Hit your notification bell so that I can notify you if you are chosen the winner as well. I do notify you via the comments section if you have been chosen the winner, but I give you very clear indications on how to reach out to me via one of my links below. So be sure to protect yourself from anybody who's posing at the Tarot Cottage. I will never send unsolicited DMs to anybody's inbox, so be sure to protect yourself from scammers. But if you are new to the channel, we would love to have you join our beautiful soul family by subscribing, hitting your notification bell, your like button. It helps me to bring you guys more content. But also, if you are interested, please drop your comment below for a chance to win a free tarot reading with me. I would love to read for you. I also offer private readings through my Etsy account, and that link is below as well. And I do update that shop daily, so be sure to check back. But for today's pick a card topic, we're looking at your future in love and who are you going to commit to? Who are you going to have a lasting relationship with? Who will you marry? We have three piles to choose from today. Pile number one here with the pink flower and the lovers. Pile number two with the hanged man and the orange flower. And pile number three here with the empress and the red flower. So whichever pile or piles are calling out to you, there may be messages waiting from spirit, and my timestamps are listed below. I'm going to jump into pile number one. Again, today we're asking spirit, who are you going to commit to? Who are you going to marry? Hello, pile number one. You are drawn to the pink flower. You are also drawn to the lovers card, and this is your reading. Who are you going to commit to? Who are you going to marry? The lovers card is a card of deep connection on so many different levels. It's not just a physical connection. It's not just an emotional connection. It's a spiritual connection too. It's like everything wrapped up into one. It could really start as a very powerful physical attraction though. And sometimes we come to know the truth by the way it feels inside. So a very powerful draw that brings the two of you together. There's a lot of Gemini energy here as well. So you could be a Gemini. Perhaps this person might be a Gemini. And what I really love is that you were drawn to the pink flower. For me, that's a beautiful symbol of the heart space opening up because of this connection as well. So very strong physical attraction, but it also actually is a precursor of the emotional connection that you're going to share with this person. I'm going to use the Disney Villains Tarot for you today. What can you tell me, please, about pile number one's future person? Who are you going to marry? What can you expect out of that connection? We have the sun. I love that. What a beautiful place to start for you, pile one. We have the two of wands. We have the King of Swords. I almost get a feeling like both of you could be air signs, or both of you could have something very similar about your sun sign, your moon, or rising. There's just something about the two of you being equal in some way. And even like an equal when it comes to my intellect, it's like a battle of wits. I feel like the conversations that the two of you have are going to be very intellectually stimulating, and then they stimulate us in other ways too. But it's just that the two of you kind of have great debates or great conversations because you're both really intelligent. You're both really smart. They're showing me that this person for you could be a collector of some kind. And when I say a collector, I mean that in the most innocent of ways. Like, I feel like they collect something specifically, and this is a message for someone specific perhaps, but they could be a collector. So this could mean they collect coins, or they collect, it could be something very different, like something very different. It's like we all have collections. We all like to collect certain things. This person feels like they have some type of collection that's really important to them. In fact, it almost seems like it has some type of narrow, nerdy interest associated with it. And they're very knowledgeable about one specific thing, like one specific hobby that they have. They're very knowledgeable about it. They could teach you everything about this one topic. And actually with the King of Swords, there could be an aspect of this person being some type of leader in education or communication in some way. So that could be surrounding their job or their career. They could use their voice in their career. (Clears throat) We have the Judgment. And I'm getting a message for someone specific as well that says that this person might notice you because you might date one of their friends or something. Like, you might be dating someone that they know, and that's how you get your introduction. It doesn't necessarily feel like this starts online or anything like that, although there's a lot of communication that starts out the flirtation. It feels like you meet them through other people. Could be even, again, a friend of a friend, or you could be casually dating someone in their friend group, and that's how they see you, or that's how they get to know you. But I also feel like this communication, these debates, these conversations that you have that are very stimulating, happen before the two of you get together. Like, it happens before the relationship is established. Here is the Four of Wands, and there is the Seven of Swords. And now I honestly feel like this is almost like a case that feels like love at first sight. And yet there's so much of the conversation that plays a role in how they feel about you or how they develop this feeling for you as well. It's like being struck by you, being struck by your beauty, being struck by your intellect, being struck by you, almost like a hypnotic energy coming through here. And it's a powerful, powerful attraction between the two of you. You can even see here with Jafar's staff, it's like something that perhaps feels like at first, like I'm not allowed to go towards it, or I shouldn't, because I feel like you meet each other through mutual friends or through mutual acquaintances or something. Because for a time, right after they find you attractive, they're going to kind of stay a little mum about it. They're not going to speak up about it at first. But this is the perfect fit for you. And truthfully, there is a serendipitous energy surrounding how you meet this person. Even if you meet them through other people, that other person's not supposed to be involved. Like, there's a reason why that other person ignites this or initiates it for you. This is the perfect fit. They're even showing Cinderella's, you know, shoe here. This is the perfect fit for you. I almost feel like, though, that, like, this person seems very long and lean. Like, I'm just seeing somebody very kind of thin, and it almost feels like opposites attract in that sense. Like, you may be a little bit shorter, they may be really tall. It just feels like kind of opposites attract in the physical sense, and yet there's something so mutual about your intellect and about the way that you guys, even the jokes that you tell, that feels kind of like somebody who has a highbrow when it comes to joke telling. Like, they have an ability to tell a really good logical joke or a joke that's really intellectual. We have the Lovers again. Lots of Leo energy, lots of Gemini energy coming through here too. There is an emphasis on the hair, and this could be your hair that they get really kind of struck by. Could be their hair, but I feel like it could be the Divine Feminine's hair that they get really struck by. Here is the Nine of Swords. And the truth is that they act really confident around you, but they are super nervous when they first meet you. There's lots of nerves. They can't stop thinking about you. They are highlighting that once the two of you are together in an established relationship, that the Divine Feminine will sometimes rule the roost. It's like they may be the head of the household, but you will be the neck that turns the head. We have the Devil, Capricorn energy. Three of Cups. As I said, it almost feels like it starts in a foundation of friendship. I feel like you could meet this person through mutual friends or even through mutual connections perhaps as well. But there's something very different about this person, and you're the perfect fit. I think they could have a different religion or some type of difference in their cultural background than you. In fact, you could be the one with a different cultural background, and that makes them feel a little bit insecure in that environment with your friends or with your family. It's like they feel a little bit out of sorts, or they feel like they don't necessarily belong at first. I will say at first. And I feel like the two of you almost agree to have a friendship at first, but that's a very unrealistic expectation. When you first meet, there's a lot of nerves associated with starting the relationship. I think because other people are I don't even want to say it's like third party. I don't think you're committed. Neither one of you are committed at that time. But it's like we just care about the opinions of other people within the dynamics of our mutual friend groups or something. So it's like we agree to just be friends, but that's very unrealistic because you guys are the perfect fit. It's the perfect fit. And sometimes we just have to speak our truth on that. It's a perfect fit. We have the Knight of Pentacles, Four of Swords with the Six of Pentacles. I feel as though the way in which you meet this person and the beginnings of your connection feel like there are some defenses that come in. It's like you guys have to defend your relationship or defend it in some way. But ultimately, there is a sense of proving that we belong together. It's like over the course of time, people, it's like the proof is in the pudding. And the two of you are committed. Like there's a commitment cycle here where you can really rely on each other. Because you're both, it's almost like we now have tunnel vision. It's just the two of us. We have tunnel vision. It's just the two of us. It doesn't matter what anybody else says. And it's like over the course of time, we're going to prove that. Because I'm getting this feeling of like that not Celine Dion, but Shania Twain song where she sings that song, Looks Like We Made It. Everybody said we wouldn't, but looks like we made it. And I think you're going to make it with this person. They're very reliable. They're very dependable when it comes to supporting you. There's the world. But I do feel like you start your relationship and you kind of keep it under wraps at first when you first begin this relationship. Who are you going to marry, please? We have a lot of Capricorn energy here as well. We have a leg up. And we have peace as well. They are highlighting children. I did see the Six of Cups in the reverse position, and they are highlighting perhaps children in the future of this connection. And that's only if you choose that. I've gotten messages before, or I've gotten little comments before in my comment section about how if you say we're gonna have children, then I'm unsubscribing because I don't want children. So Spirit says if that is in your heart space, if that is something you desire, that could be an opportunity in this connection as well. They are indicating that this could be a path that troubles your heart or that you're worried about it as well, but they still see you being successful there. Even if you need a little bit of help, even if you need a little bit of confidence, they still see you being successful there. Also have the higher power. And we have in between worlds and the fates. So you may not be in a relationship right now. You may be worried about what the future holds in love for you. And that could be what's troubling your heart in this moment. So your higher self is coming forward to give you the leg up, to ask you to trust in your own intuition, to trust in God, to trust in the serendipity of your future. And in this moment, you're just in the in-between. And your work, the work that you have to do, is drop your guard, drop your defenses, and prepare with your heart space. And that could be why you are drawn to the pink flower, is to prepare your heart space to be vulnerable in the in-between. Because if you can set that standard now, then you'll be like a launching pad of success for the future when this energy does show up for you. So it is fated. Your guides say you don't have to worry about this person crossing paths with you. They will cross your path. And then ultimately, they see you taking the leaps of faith that are necessary to reach you to your victory and reach you to your collaboration here. I love that the Four of Wands is here. I love that we can see the Seven of Swords poking out too, because this is a launching pad of you having upgrades, of you being delivered from the past. So if you are currently not in a relationship, your guides are saying, hold on, the best is still coming. We have here Mary Magdalene. And this card comes out here of the Magdalene Oracle. And, you know, she was very much misunderstood. And I feel like there's a certain amount of misunderstandings that could surround the attraction to this person in the future for you. Again, especially surrounding your friend groups. But there's a loyalty to each other. Like there's a certain amount of loyalty to each other. We have gratitude coming in as well, and illumination on the back of the deck. So in this moment, an attitude of gratitude is going to lead us to the confidence that we need to push ourselves through any obstacles that could happen at the very beginnings of this connection, when we start to form the relationship, when we start that back and forth flirtation that we're so nervous about. Who are you going to marry? What can you tell me about that relationship, please, for pile number one? We have here past life relationship. You've known each other before. I also saw masks being worn. Again, you might kind of hide your relationship at first because you're afraid of what other people will say. Getting to know each other, as you reveal your innermost selves to each other, your bond is going to deepen. And then we also have, yes, this is your soulmate. This is something that was meant, coming from a past life, meant to revisit you in this lifetime so that we can continue the process of overcoming our karmic trenches together. I feel like right out of the gate in this relationship, that's where a big hurdle for the two of you in overcoming some past karmic trenches will be available to you. But I also see you being successful. I also see this being a very happy relationship. When we start with this, with the sun, it's always a beautiful situation, no matter what. And then we have the lovers, which you started with your back of deck. So a relationship that is meant to help us grow, meant to help us see things from different perspectives, and ultimately will lead you to a lot of abundance. Let's get a charm bowl, please, for pile number one. What can you tell me about this person, about who they will marry? Six of Swords. I feel like it's like the two of you against the world. That's what it feels like, the two of you against the world. We have the world. We have the Ten of Pentacles. Now, they're talking about unfinished cycles for you currently in this present moment and how you could be worried about this person showing up in the first place. You could also have a timing delay or timing concern surrounding family, surrounding that type of outcome as well. And this person could be sort of the missing key or the missing piece to that outcome coming into fruition for you. That's why there's been a delay there, because this person hasn't shown up yet and they're destined for you. In the bowl, we have the baby carriage. We have love on a foundation, so definite commitment cycles here. The letter Q and Z. We have the empty heart with the heart as well, reversed. And the Two of Cups. I feel like this is like a reference to where you're currently sitting in your love realm, pile one. But there's the Two of Cups. And here's the dime as well. I always think of the Ten of Swords with the dime, and actually the Six of Swords in transition. So your expectations of perhaps having an empty heart, spirit says that's not going to come to fruition for you. We have 2009 as a date here on the dime. I also think of October and Libra. We have a lot of Gemini, but the King of Swords could definitely be another air element of Libra as well. So a collaboration coming in to help you transition into clarity and peace. Also the honey cells, and the honey cells are all filled. They're talking about a connection that will last, because honey never goes bad. All right, pile number one, that's what I have for you today. I hope it resonates with you. If it does, drop your comment below for a chance to win a reading with me. You can also check out my link for Etsy for a personal reading, and I do update that shop daily, so keep checking back. But I hope that you come back here and visit me at the Tarot Cottage, and I hope you have a great day. Hello, pile number two. You were drawn to the orange flower and to the Hanged Man, and this is your reading. Who are you going to commit to? Who are you going to marry in the future? The Hanged Man here, there's a feeling of like watch and wait. Wait to see what spirit has coming for you. Wait to see what spirit has in store for you as well. We have the orange flower as well. I think they're trying to empower you with a sense of invigoration, because you may feel like you've been held back. You may feel like you've just been waiting and waiting and waiting to seek out more information, but they say that that information is coming. And I just keep getting this sense of like, you just wait and see. So I'm going to use, I don't know why I can never remember the name of the Herb Crafter's Tarot for you. I can never remember the name of this deck. So the Herb Crafter's Tarot, please, for pile number two. Who are they going to marry? Ten of Swords coming out right now with the alfalfa. You may have like an expectation that you're holding right now. Maybe it's towards a certain person, or maybe it's just towards love in general. And it may not be a very good expectation with the Ten of Swords, to be honest. And Spirit's asking us to kind of give ourselves some time, give them time to work and reveal something to you, because alfalfa is grown in fields that have been overrun by corn or soya for a while. So they'll grow alfalfa for a season to replenish the soil. And so they are talking about how maybe this moment in time, it doesn't feel like you've arrived yet, but give yourself some time and give them some time to show you what they're planting, because they're planting something for you. And they want to remind you that all flowers, all crops have to grow through the dirt. So we all have to have this breakthrough. We all have to struggle to push through to our breakthroughs. So they're trying to acknowledge if you are struggling right now in staying optimistic and in staying positive. We have here the Eight of Pentacles, turmeric. And with turmeric, it's a beautiful, I don't want to call it an herb. What is it? Like a spice. It's great for inflammation. So they're talking about feeling kind of inflamed, feeling insecure perhaps. And again, there's the line of clothes. Being hung out to dry in some way is how you could be feeling. Here's the Knight of Swords. We have the Seven of Fire. And we have the Five of Wands. Now your first spread here, Pile 2, is really trying to address where you're sitting in your energy field here too, because they're trying to ask you to be flexible with your disappointment. In this moment, you may feel, again, very disappointed with where you're sitting in love right now, but they're singing that song Strawberry Wine to me, and they're bringing in the Star of Aquarius, and they're speaking about how they want you to be more flexible with hope. Be more flexible with where your gaze is sitting right this moment. Because again, you don't see everything. You're just jumping to conclusions in this moment. Even the Knight of Swords here, who is normally on horseback and goes rushing towards some type of declaration, it's a sitz bath. And so it's like they're asking us to cool our jets or to cool our lower chakras a little bit to build up the confidence that this person is coming in for you. That it is coming in. They're highlighting the star. And they're highlighting, again, the reality of the weight, the reality of the burn for us in the present moment. But they're like, you don't know what's coming. Here's your High Priestess. There's your Seven of Cups. It's like we have an option. Part of our mastery, even in love, is about how we respond to outside stimulus. How do we respond to this moment in time? When things don't seem like they're going our way, what's our natural emotional response to that? And do we jump to conclusions based on fear? Because they are indicating here, I think you could have a Leo, Aries, Sagittarius that comes in for you. And they're speaking about this person being very protective of you. And also this person, their arrival in your life being protected. We have the Judgment coming through. Page of Swords. The Two of Pentacles and the Six of Wands. I love that. We have the five of Wands. We have the Six of Wands here as well. That's the 11 of Justice. We have the Temperance and the Two of Cups. Now they are indicating that you've been patient. Perhaps you have to continue to be a little bit patient before you reach the beginnings of this relationship. Now for someone, you may already be involved with someone, and maybe you're just waiting for this person to commit to you. There's just a sense of your foundation has already began, or the foundation has already been established towards expansion. And that could mean that you're already dating someone, or you're already invested with someone, and you want to know if this is your person. Your guides say that this could be your person if that's the case. If you haven't met this person yet, Spirit says again, they're like, surrender to what's being required of you, or what's being asked of you, which is a sense of finding joy within the journey and being more flexible with our expectations. Again, if you're in a relationship in this present moment, they're still asking for more time. They're still asking for what is available to you in this connection to be revealed to you in the future. If you aren't in a relationship, this is coming in for you very quickly. They say that it's going to be coming in for you. The commitment cycle is going to be coming in for you within the next perhaps 2 years. So that can mean you're already established in something, and in 2 years you'll be in that commitment cycle. Or within this next 2 years, you're meeting them, you're establishing that connection. But there's this season with the alfalfa where Spirit just wants us to wait to see what's been planted, wait to see what is replenishing the soil and what's going to come out of this situation right now. They want us to take a pause with the Knight of Swords, even though the Knight of Swords, again, tells us to get into action. In this case, It's being supported by the page, who's just watching and learning and gathering all this information. Because you're not only learning perhaps more about a new person or about a current connection or about a connection that's coming in, but you're also learning how to navigate your own heart space within the dynamics of those relationships. And all of those skills are so important for you to establish and to create in an abundant life with another person. I feel like this person, again, is very protective. I'm almost getting a sense of someone who could have a military background or even like a police officer background, something like that. Like, they take that seriously, the role of being a protector, very seriously. And they're speaking here about, like, again, if you're in a relationship, this could lead to the marriage that you're looking for. And your work is, how do you enjoy the process of getting to the altar? It's like, we don't live for the moment that we're going to commit to each other. We live for every single moment leading up to those checkpoints. And so the work you're doing now may be in surrendering to the journey, not putting too much expectation or pressure on the future outcome. They keep saying, cool your jets, because all paths lead home for you. All paths lead to victory. And if you can really hold on to that faith base, then Spirit says nothing can stop you. What can you tell me about this person, please? King of Pentacles, extremely good looking energy coming through here. And that could be the basis of, like, meeting them. You could have been very physically attracted to them. I just feel like they have very strong features. If they are the divine masculine, they have very strong masculine features, like square jaw. I just feel like, do you know who they're showing me is, like, Kronk from Emperor's New Groove? How it's like the triangle shape, right? The narrow hips, the wide shoulders. Very good looking energy. And honestly, very commitment focused. Somebody who's going to be... someone who would be a good dad and a good provider. That's coming forward as well. Ace of Wands. I will say, a little bit of a tire kicker when it comes to, like, and they're showing me, like, literally buying a truck or buying a car or something like that. It's like, if they're going to buy something that's a big purchase, this is someone who does research. This is somebody who doesn't jump to action, and that could be why they don't jump to the altar too, because that's just their type, that's just their energy field. They're cautious, they make good decisions, they make practical decisions, and they're very smart. They may not kind of consider themselves book smart, but they are, like, they're just a very intelligent person. But this is also the type of person that could fix things easily, because they're really smart. They're really good with their hands. They're really good at fixing things that break down. I feel like they could fix a car. So there could be a mechanic energy in their background too. We have the Three of Wands. Back of the deck, we have the Ace of Swords, and we have the Two of Pentacles. They're also highlighting someone, and this could be you, that has almost made it to a commitment cycle before in the past, and then it didn't work out. And so there's that fear that's part of your inflammation that Spirit wants us to reflect upon, that's going to come to the surface in this relationship. It's like sometimes we will punish our current partners for things that happened in the past, because it's like we're so afraid. We want them to reassure us, even if it's not their job or their work to do it. It's like we look to them for that reassurance. I feel like this person gives that reassurance to you though. And again, there's all paths that lead home to you. Look at the break in this river, but it all leads home. So there is a certain amount of patience that I feel like you're going to have to apply to this relationship before you reach the success of the altar. And that, I feel like, will be one of the biggest challenges that the two of you face, is what you would perceive as delays and what Spirit's calling as patience. Because this person has intention. They just don't want to let you in on their intention, especially when it comes to asking you to marry them or to ask you to commit to them. They're not going to be the type that talks about it beforehand. They're going to be the type that surprises you. Six of Swords, the World, and the Fool. Back of the deck is the Judgment, And there's that Knight of Swords. Don't rush to judgment. That's what I'm hearing. Don't rush to judgment. Get yourself in an energy field where you're just prepared to launch, where you're feeling so optimistic. You're like holding on to the mentality of a child where you are so confident that you're just sure. You're just confident that the universe is going to catch you. You know, the difference between paranoia is being pro-noia and just assuming that everything is going to work out for you. That's kind of the work that you're being called to do in this present moment. They're also saying here for anyone who is interested in that outcome that there could be children associated, at least one child in the very least, associated with this union as well. And I feel like that really completes the picture. I also feel like there's a fear associated with that about raising children, being capable enough. That could be coming from the divine masculine. But again, spirit's like, this is a good egg. This would be somebody who is a good provider and a good father figure. And I only use the term father figure for ease of execution. It can be the divine feminine. It can be the divine masculine. It's all about energy. Who are you going to marry? You could currently be in this relationship right this moment. You could currently be in the relationship of the person you're going to commit to. We have here, go the distance. And normally the cheetah has to be ready to sprint into action. And yet this card says go the distance. It's like making sure that we are not trying to sprint, but that we're willing, even though we want to sprint to the outcome, we're willing to find the joy in the journey. That's part of your temperance. That's part of your alchemy in this lifetime. And this person's going to help you get there. I just saw higher power. We have chop wood. And they're encouraging us in this moment to do some wood chopping when it comes to our own perspective and when it comes to jumping or rushing to a conclusion. I just heard we're still learning to love. We're still learning to love ourselves. We're still learning to love others. And we have exchanging gifts. And I love that this little ballerina is popping up out of this box. And there's something beautiful about vulnerability and exchanging gifts with each other. Somebody having the courage to handle this situation with grace. That could be your energy, handling this connection with grace before there is this exchange of gifts. And the biggest exchange we're doing here is surrendering to the flow, surrendering to what's being offered to us, and honestly enjoying the process, because we have a choice. Spirit says we can move through this cycle. We can move through maybe our current relationship or relationships coming in, dragging our feet and really being insecure about what that next step is bringing us. Or we can just surrender to the flow, lift up our feet and just let it carry us. They're actually showing me like when I was a kid and I used to slip underneath my mom's shopping cart and I would just lay under there and she'd just drive me around the store. That's what they're showing me. It's like you can just go with the flow and see where this is going to carry you. That's why you started with the Hanged Man, because Spirit's like, you don't realize what's going to be shown to you. You just have to show, I don't want to use a word like patience, because Spirit says that we've created this idea of impatience in the collective when everything's happening exactly as it's supposed to. We have chemistry. There is a strong magnetic attraction that will bring the two of you together. This could currently be happening in the present moment if you are currently in a relationship and you're just waiting. It's like you're waiting for the commitment cycles. It says, keep an open mind. Your soulmate may differ from your usual type or expectations. And we have engagement. Your love life is ascending to a higher level of commitment. Spirit says you just have to surrender to what's going to be revealed to you next. Let's get a charm here for pile number two. Advice for pile number two about who will you marry? Judgment. The World reversed. You're not finished yet. I think the World came in the first pile as well. And here is the Wheel of Fortune in the reverse position too. So I feel like there's a really strong call to judgment, because we keep having it brought up multiple times in your spread here as well. To reflect, and a judgment isn't for us to judge others, but it's for us to judge ourselves and what feels like it's missing, what's making us feel imbalanced, what's unfinished for us, why do we feel so stuck and stagnant, why is it making us feel a little bit of out of control? Because we all want to micromanage, especially the divine feminine, because we've always felt through the past generations, we've had so many examples and experiences of feeling unsafe in what's going to happen next and having no say, that we want all the answers. We want to know everything to see if it's in alignment with us. And so you may be feeling that in this moment, but part of your call to action now is to give yourself the permission to surrender to the moment, to surrender to this moment, and not have to step back into your divine feminine power where you are not chasing, you are receiving all of the energy that is deserving of you. And it's hard work. Spirit acknowledges that that's hard work. But all paths lead home for you. So we have here, we have me, exclamation point. We have O and G, just go, it's go time. We also have here the snake. I think about the temperance too, like the Kundalini awakening. We have Hello Kitty and Divine Feminine standing at attention with the happy charm. Like they want you to feel abundant today in this moment, because that's a beautiful seed of positivity and abundance that's going to be fueling the next moment and the next moment. We also have the tree of life, so commitment cycles and sort of planting seeds that will extend generationally. So there could be children involved in your future as well. All right, pile number three, two. That's what I have for you today. I hope it resonates with you. If it does, please drop your comment below for a chance to win a reading with me. You can also check out my link for Etsy for a personal reading if you feel called to. And I do update that shop daily, so keep checking back. But I hope that you come back here and visit me at the Tarot Cottage, and I hope that you have a beautiful day. Hello, pile number three. You are drawn to the red flower. You're also drawn to the beautiful Empress energy, and this is your reading. Who are you going to commit to? Who are you going to marry? What can spirit tell you about that connection? Now, you are drawn to the beautiful red flower of empowerment. You're also drawn to this gorgeous Empress energy, and she is abundance in every form. She represents every type of abundance, whether it be a financial abundance, relationship abundance, children, family, whatever your goals are in your relationship cycle, you can be empowered by this connection, and you yourself have enough energy and momentum to empower yourself towards that outcome. So let's take a look here. I'm going to use the Santa Morte Book of the Dead Tarot for you. Who are you going to commit to? Who are you going to marry, please, for pile number three? Who is pile number three going to commit to or marry, please? We have the Queen of Wands and the Sun. We have the Chariot. We have the Ten of Pentacles. We have the Seven of Cups. We have the Eight of Cups. We have the Page of Swords, oops, along with the Hermit. Back of the deck, we have the Four of Wands, and we have that beautiful Empress energy coming out as well. So let's clarify as we go forward here. Can we clarify, please, the Queen of Wands and the Sun? Who is pile number three going to marry and commit to? We have the Six of Wands showing with the Two of Pentacles, and they were already showing me the Two of Pentacles with those two acoustic guitars. We have the Page of Swords and the Two of Cups coming out as well. I want to keep those because I feel like there is a sense of having already feeling like I've arrived or feeling like I've found my person in the past. And this is the recent past or could be the extended past, but maybe you've had a commitment cycle, or maybe you really thought, I've arrived, I've found my person, this is it for me. And so there's a sense of a lot of lessons that have come in your relationship cycles in the recent past, actually. Five of Swords. And I do feel like there's a certain amount of conflict coming from those past energies. Spirit wants you to consider that your future in love and your future in commitment cycles might rest somewhere different than someone from your past. Because I do see a brand new energy coming forward for you. And the truth is that it's so much more abundant than what you've experienced in the past. Even if you thought you had arrived in the past in a commitment cycle, even if you thought this is my person, there's no one in the world that could possibly be for me, your guides are saying that you're learning a lot. And there's a lot of like spades being thrown around. It's like calling a spade a spade. And the Spirit's showing a lot of reality checks that have hit you or will hit you in the very near future. I feel like there's already current conflict. I feel like that's why you even came or were drawn to this question, because you want to know, is this person from my recent past or maybe someone I'm currently in conflict with, are they the one for me? Because maybe I was really sure about it. I felt like I had arrived, but now I'm emotionally being pulled in different directions and I want to know, are there options for me in the future? And your guides are here to say yes. They're saying that a complacency or a lack of momentum in old relationships or current relationships are actually here to help provide a roadmap. And some of this, for some, this roadmap may lead you elsewhere. But they're also almost thanking the energies that have brought you here. And they're thanking these collaborators that have brought you to this perspective, because Spirit says it's a twin flame launch that's helping to get you where you need to be, which is right here. On your throne, where you deserve. And they understand that it's like they're showing the Yule log getting pushed into the fire, like inch by inch, mile by mile. And so they're, and actually now they're showing me I Love Lucy, that scene where she opens up the oven and the bread comes out and just keeps coming. The bread just keeps coming. And so they're speaking about that, about how certain things have revealed themselves to you. And it's like, I can't stop that revelation now. I can't stop the truths that have been revealed to me in my love cycles. They just keep coming at me. And the Spirit's not trying to hurt you by revealing these truths in your current conflicts. They're trying to free you. They're trying to get you over that hurdle. Because here at the Eight of Cups, we can't deny that the Eight of Cups is walking away perhaps from something so that I can find more fulfillment in myself. Even here at the Ace of Cups, I need to walk away so I can find peace, so I can fill up my cup again, so I can learn the lesson, so I can apply that lesson to my path. They're talking about the last 2 years, maybe even connection, like these next 2 years or the last 2 years of your life bringing you to this place. We have the Star of Aquarius here. We have the Knight of Wands showing itself here with the Wheel of Fortune. And then there's the Queen of Pentacles. There could be a lot of fire in your future. You could be a fire sign, a Leo, Aries, Sagittarius. You could have an Aquarius energy coming forward, or actually another fire sign coming forward, because I'm getting a lot of Sagittarius energy for you in the future. And the truth is that, oh, sorry, I banged you. The truth is that Spirit's saying that this next chapter in love for you, you may feel like you don't want to commit. You may feel like you don't want to agree to anything or really focus on commitment cycles. And that's okay. They're just encouraging you in this next chapter to take action towards this person. They're talking about somebody with a lot of energy coming forward for you. There could actually be a slight discrepancy in age, like they could be a little bit younger than you, but not by a lot. But it's just their energy. It's like they have a lot of charisma. They have a lot, they have a great sense of humor. It's like they are exactly the type of person you need to change your direction, to change your approach in some way, to help that healing cycle. They're very inspirational, just with the amount of optimism that they have. They inspire you. There's something that you learn from them, you know, and it doesn't even feel like a typical education. You learn from them because of the way that they apply themselves to life. They're just very exuberant. They have a lot of energy. They have great ideas. They like to travel. And this gets you moving in a new direction. And I feel like the next 2 years for you are very critical in your love journey. And in the next 2 years, you may be walking away from something to find yourself. And what you're going to find is you are going to find yourself. But as soon as you find yourself, someone else is going to find you too. And there's so much, they help bring your confidence back up. It's through their influence, they help to bring your confidence back up, because they are very attracted to you. Like this person that you're going to commit with ultimately is very, very attracted to you. They tell you every day that you're attractive. They tell you every day what you're worth. And at first, you maybe don't believe them, but it starts to sink in and you start to believe it. I almost feel like you communicate to this person in the future that you want more, that you want more commitment with them. And I think that they're right on board with you at that time as well. What can you tell me about this person, please? And again, there's almost like a thankfulness or like a request to thank the energies that are going to carry you to this person. It's like this person will look at your past and be like, I'm really glad that they treated you like that. I'm so glad that they weren't right for you. I'm so glad that they hurt you, because if they hadn't have done that, you wouldn't be with me. And like, that's the mentality that they have. And they help you to see that as well. We have the Lovers. And there's the Knight of Wands. I will say this person feels very intuitive. They're also like, they're really, really smart, but it's, and they're very intuitive, but it's like they don't trust their own intuition. I don't know why that's coming through. But what I really love is that there's something here about, I'm hearing that song Umbrella from Rihanna, because they want to shelter you. There's a protection, there's a loyalty that they want to protect you from as well. And this is the type of person too, that they're never going to let you speak poorly of yourself. Like never. This person would never ever stand for it. They're not going to put up with it. If you start to speak poorly about yourself, they are shutting it down. And the physical attraction that you feel, I feel like you go into it not expecting this to go anywhere because they're so different from your past. And maybe again, a little bit younger, a little bit less what you would say is mature. It's like you don't see it going anywhere, but it really goes everywhere. Yeah, it goes to the wand. It goes here to the Chariot, the Ace of Swords. But the Ace of Swords is really highlighting a new perspective and a fresh approach. It's like this is somebody very different from your past expectations. This is somebody very different from previous partners, or even from current partners that you're having a lot of confusing conflicts with. There's a sense of you kind of taking off on your own, or expecting to go off on this independent journey. And the truth is that as soon as you kind of propel yourself outward and seek out something for yourself, as soon as you walk away from something unfulfilling, it's like very quickly after that, like a month later, you meet this person. Because it's almost as if the universe was just waiting for that one last push before it gave you the desires of your heart that you've always wanted in the first place. I feel like this person will travel a lot with you. There's a lot of travel energy between the two of you as well. And they make you feel so beautiful and so attractive. Can you tell me about the future with this person, please? We have the Three of Pentacles. And they are speaking here about building a foundation with one expectation and then having to extend that expectation outwards. It's like they're showing me like the clumsiness of the panda bear and having to climb up that bamboo, but there's like a sense of not expecting this to go anywhere, but it does. Yeah, with time, there's the beautiful Empress. It all comes back to you. It all comes back to your abundance. There is an emphasis on motherhood here. There's been an emphasis on children on all three piles. That doesn't have to resonate with you unless that's your goal. But specifically for pile three here, there is an emphasis on perhaps that being a goal for you. And motherhood would be something that you would achieve in this connection as well. But I think that you take your time to get there. Like you don't force that forward. Because it's fun. This person makes life fun. And there's no rush. We have a round and round. And I do feel like this, first of all, they're talking about past life connection, but they're also speaking about certain loops that you may feel stuck in when it comes to conflicts in your relationship. And they're asking you to explore options. If that's the case for you in this present moment, you may not be feeling very satisfied. And if that's the case, your guides say it may be time in the future to move away or walk away, rather. We have here the Yin, again, Divine Feminine. Just open your cup to receive. Back of the deck says a leg up. They're referencing motherhood, but they're also referencing allowing someone to help you. Allowing someone to come in and be a force that helps to propel you forward. That's why they're really emphasizing, because you may not feel, again, because it almost feels like that you meet this person right off, piggybacking off the back of another relationship, or you meet them like a month later and you have no intention of going into a relationship. It's like you want to claim an independent cycle, but Spirit says it's very quick in succession of leaving something behind and moving on to something else. And the truth is that it may be just exactly what you need to go towards the abundance that you've been waiting for all along. It's almost like you're used to waiting. So it's like, I'll wait. It's like, I'm used to waiting. But your guides say that the wait is, you deserve more. You don't deserve to wait any longer. And that's why they're encouraging you not to wait when you do meet this person, to leap into action. Because ultimately, if you hold back, you're just holding back your abundance, your commitment cycles, your feelings of empowerment, your good luck. It says here, worth waiting for. Divine timing was at work in your love life. And they are highlighting this next 2 years for you being very significant to carry you to your victory. I feel like they're including part of this year, however. And new love, a new person will stir your romantic feelings. Again, I feel like there's something you're leaving behind in order to go in towards a brand new relationship. And everything's happening exactly as it's supposed to, with hidden blessings that you will understand. We have religious factors. Your love life is influenced by your religious upbringing and spiritual path. And this could, every time I see the religious factors card, I think about relationships that aren't built on love, that are built on responsibility. And that's not what I'm feeling coming forward for you. So you may feel that that's something that you've established in the past in your commitment cycles of like, this is the expectation. I've invested here. Now the expectation is that I just see it through. But your guides are encouraging you to seek out your own abundance, to seek out fulfillment for yourself. We do have calling in your soulmate. Your prayers, affirmations, and visualizations help to bring you closer together. So ultimately, you can see that the Divine Feminine is calling. It's like a desire from the heart based on a reality of grief that is expressed from her heart space. And so in this moment, your guide's saying they're just corresponding to the nature of your call. They're bringing in this energy. They're bringing in all of this change because you've called for it, because your heart needs it, or your heart has called for it. Let's get a charm bowl, please, for pile number 3. Tell me about this person coming forward. 10 of Cups. I love that for you. The Judgment, the World reverse. The World has come in the reverse for every single pile today, actually, because you're not finished. You're not done. And so there's an unfinished cycle here. But what I love for you, pile 3, is that the 10 of Cups is waiting for you. The full spectrum. And it hasn't been shown to you yet. It hasn't been shown to you yet, but they are, again, they're speaking about this next 10 months being significant and the next 2 years being very significant. So you may meet this person within the next 9 to 10 months, and then ultimately it could be the next 2 years before you move into a commitment cycle, but your guides are encouraging you to have fun with it and to enjoy the journey. They're even highlighting with that Judgment on a sideways sort of angle that you may not even feel ready for a brand new day, but it's coming. We have T and N. We also have saxophone. I think of longing. It's like, I think of those 90s music videos where we're on the beach playing the saxophone in this longing type of energy. We have forever and we have song. We also have an open book here and it has fairies written all over it. So there's like a feeling of wondering if the desires of my heart and love are just kind of a dream or a fairy tale. We have our High Priestess with the curled shell, and we also have the bicycle, and I do think of a chariot energy, but I think of children associated with it. So decisions we make because of children or for children. There could also be a little secret coming in from your higher self about children coming in the future and being a driving force towards your decisions, your leaps of faith. Pile number 3, that's what I have for you today. Hope it resonates. If it does, drop your comment below for a chance to win a reading with me. You can also check out my link for Etsy for a personal reading if you feel called to. And I hope that you come back here and visit me at the Tarot Cottage. And I hope you have a great day.